Hello everyone, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about a very simple and fundamental non-linear circuit element, which is a diode. Okay, right. So let us look at some of the important basics of diode, which is a two-terminal device. As I told earlier, that a diode is a very simple and a fundamental non-linear circuit element. Okay, so diode is a very simple and fundamental non-linear circuit element. So far we have seen the linear circuit elements like your resistor, capacitor and so on. So the first non-linear device or the element that we could see is the two terminal device diode. Okay, right. Okay, so let me give you some important properties of the diode, like what is the symbolic representation of the diode. Okay, the symbolic representation of the diode is as shown here. Okay, this terminal is being denoted by P and this terminal is being denoted by N. Okay, so this is the symbolic representation of the diode. And one of the important property of a diode is whenever the diode is being said to be forward biased, it conducts only in one direction. So that is in the direction in accordance with this arrow symbol. I think you could see in the diode symbol itself, there is an arrow here. Okay, there is an arrow here, right? So when I close this, you could see an arrow. So that arrow is representing the current flowing through your diode when it is forward biased. Okay, when your diode is said to be forward biased, or when your diode is being operated in the forward bias region, then the current is going to flow from P side to the N side. Let it be denoted with ID. Okay, let it be denoted with ID. Okay, let the voltage applied across the diode be VD. Okay, so whenever a diode is said to be forward biased, okay, then there results some current that is flowing through your device from P side to the N side. Okay, and this bar is representing, okay, and this bar is representing that your diode does not conduct in the other direction, that is from N side to the P side. Your diode does not allow the current flow. Okay, your diode does not allow the current flow from N side to the P side. So that is what this symbolic representation is. Diode conducts only in one direction. Diode does not conduct in the other direction. It is a unidirectional device, right? At least ideally. Okay, at least ideally, right? So wherever your diode is said to be forward biased, okay, whenever your diode is said to be forward biased, current results from P side to the N side. Okay, so what do you mean by exactly forward biased means? Okay, forward biased means potential at P side should be more than potential at N side, then you say that your diode is said to be forward biased. Okay, what do you mean by forward biased? If potential at P side is more than potential at N side, then you say that your diode is said to be forward biased. Okay, if your potential at P side, okay, is less than your potential at N side, then you say that your diode is said to be in reverse biased. Okay, so this is the basic definition of whether your device is in the forward biased or reverse biased. Okay, so when will you say that your diode is in the forward biased? When the potential at P side is more than the potential at N side, then you say that it is forward biased. When your potential at P side is less than the potential at N side, or in other words, potential at N side is more than the potential at P side, then you say that your diode is said to be in the reverse biased. Okay, so the primary concept here is, when your diode is said to be forward biased, okay, your diode is said to be positive, that is flowing through your device, that is always from P side to the N side. When your diode is said to be reverse biased, then your diode current is said to be zero. Okay, then your diode current is said to be zero. Okay, is this okay? Right? Okay. Now you tell me that is this diode is forward biased or reverse biased, because my potential at P side is 6 volts and potential at N is 2 volts. Vp is greater than Vn, so my diode is said to be forward biased. So definitely there results some current Id, which is always positive. Okay, in this particular case, my potential connected to the P side is 3 volts, potential connected to the N side is 5 volts, and because Vp is less than Vn, or voltage connected to N side is more than the voltage connected to the P side, my current that is flowing here through the diode is 0. Okay, right? So just looking at whether my P side potential is more than the N side or P side potential is less than the N side, accordingly we will decide that whether my diode is either forward biased or reverse biased. Okay, region of operation of the diode. So far we have seen that diode can be operated either in the forward bias or in the reverse bias, and we have seen that when diode is forward biased, current flows from P to N side, and if it is reverse biased, current is zero. Okay, so now let us try to understand how to test that whether the diode is in which type of region of operation, that is whether diode is in forward biased or reverse biased, how to test. Okay, there are two types of tests here. One is open circuit test. Okay, one is open circuit test, another is short circuit test, that we will be using either of these tests for determining whether diode is forward biased or reverse biased. Okay, so let us consider a diode, right? Let us consider a diode. In the open circuit test, what we will be doing is we will be making our diode open circuit. Okay, we will be making our diode open circuit. Then I am going to try to find out what is my voltage across the diode. If my voltage across the diode is found to be positive, it is said to be forward biased. If I find my voltage across the diode to be negative, I will say that this is reverse biased. Okay, this is what is the test that we are going to perform. Open circuit test. You remove your diode and you try to find out the voltage across the diode with plus sign towards this P side and a minus sign with the N side. Then if you find your Vd as positive greater than 0, then you say that your diode is said to be forward biased. If you find your Vd as a negative, then you say that your diode is going to be reverse biased. But remember that always you are trying to find the voltage across the diode with a plus sign tied towards the P and a minus sign tied towards the N. Okay, right. So in the short circuit test, what we will be doing is we will replace the diode with a short circuit. Okay, we will replace the diode with a short circuit. Okay, here V is 0. Okay, V is 0, right? This is your P side, this is your N side. Okay, now I'll try to find the current that is flowing through your diode. Then if I find my current through the diode is greater than 0, that is positive, then I'll say that my diode is said to be forward biased. If my diode is current is negative, then I'll say that it is a reverse biased. Okay, so these are the two types of tests that we will be applying. One is open circuit test, another is short circuit test. The open circuit test, open your diode, then find out the voltage. If diode voltage is positive, forward biased. Diode voltage is negative, then it is reverse biased. In short circuit test, short your diode, then find out the current. When you just made your diode shorted, voltage across the diode is 0. So just find out the current through the diode. So if your current is positive, forward biased. If your current is negative, reverse biased. Okay, right. Let us try to find out whether this diode is forward biased or reverse biased. Okay, so and what are the tests that we are having? One is either short circuit or the open circuit. Let us try to apply an open circuit test. Okay, so in the open circuit test, what we will be doing, we will be making our diode open circuit, right? Then now we are interested in finding what is my voltage across the diode. My voltage across the diode I need to find out, and if I find my voltage across the diode as positive, I say that my diode, this diode is said to be forward biased.
If I find this VD as negative, then I will say that this diode is reverse biased. Let us try to find out what is the voltage across this diode. Okay. So as this is an open circuit, what is the current that is flowing through this? Current that is flowing through this is zero. Okay. So when the current flowing through this is zero, there will be no drop across this. So my voltage from here to here, to the plus terminal, it is connected to 3, and to the negative, it is connected 1. So my VD is being given as 3 minus 1, that is equal to 2 volts, which is a positive. So when my VD is positive, I will say that my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. I can find out that my diode is forward biased. Okay. Even I can apply a short circuit test also. Okay. Why I need to apply only open circuit test? I can apply the short circuit test also. Okay. Let me apply the short circuit test. In the short circuit test, I will be shorting my diode. Then I will try to find out what is my current through the diode. Okay. I will try to find out what is my current through the diode. What is my current through the diode? My current through the diode is nothing but current through the 4 kilo ohm resistor, and which is being given by 3 minus 1 by 4. So that is ID is equal to 3 minus 1 by 4 milliamperes, which is nothing but 2 by 4, that is 0.5 milliamperes. As this is greater than 0, my ID is greater than 0, so my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. As my ID is greater than 0, my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. So in either way, whether you perform either short circuit test or an open circuit test, in either case, you will be finding that your diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. Right. Let us take another example. Okay. Now let us try to find out whether my diode is said to be either forward biased or reverse biased. Again, as usual, let us try to apply a short circuit test. In the short circuit test, I will be replacing my diode with a short circuit. Then I will be trying to find out my current through the diode. So if my diode current is positive, I will say that my diode is said to be forward biased. If my current is negative, then I will say that my diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay. So let us try to find out the current that is flowing through the diode under a case that your assumption is diode is short circuit. Okay. So what is my current is being given by ID is equal to, okay, ID is nothing but the current flowing through your 3 kilo ohm resistor in this direction. So that is the voltage is minus 3 minus minus 6 divided by 3 kilo ohm, that is milliamperes. Okay. So minus 3 plus 6, okay, is plus 3, 3 by 3 is 1, so 1 milliampere. Okay. So as my ID is positive here, okay, as my ID is positive here, I'll say that my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. So this diode in this circuit arrangement is acting in the forward bias region. Okay. Right. When I apply the open circuit test, what is that I can do? I can replace my diode with open circuit. Then I will try to find out my voltage. See, you can observe that I am trying to find out my voltage always with plus terminal at P side and minus terminal at the N side. So I am interested in finding my voltage in with this polarity only. Okay. So now you find out your voltage. If you find your voltage to be positive, I say that my diode is said to be forward biased. If you find your voltage to be negative, I say that my diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay. Let us try to find out what is my voltage. Whenever this is open circuit, current through this is zero. So naturally the drop across this 3 kilo ohm is zero. So my voltage from plus to minus is given by my VD is equal to, okay, minus 3 minus of minus 6 volts. So what is this is 3 volts. So as my VD is positive, that is greater than zero. Okay. I'll say that my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay. So whether you proceed with either short circuit test or an open circuit test, you could find that your diode in this given circuit is said to be in the forward biased region. Okay. Let us consider the third example. Again, some question is being given. where you need to find out whether your diode is forward biased or reverse biased. Okay, let us apply a short circuit test where you will be replacing your diode with a short circuit. Then you are interested in finding your current through the diode in the direction from P to N. If your current is found to be positive, then you say that your diode is said to be forward biased. If your current is said to be negative, then you say that your diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay. So can you find out your current through the diode? -4, -0 by 4 milliamperes. So that means my ID in this case is a negative. Okay. So my ID in this case is -4 by 4 is -1. So that means my diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay. As I could define that my ID as negative, my diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay, so the same can be holding good even when I apply my open circuit test also. Okay, so let us see that I am applying an open circuit test. Okay, so in the open circuit test, I'll be opening my diode. Okay, then I mean to find out the voltage across the diode. If my voltage across the diode is positive, then I'll say that my diode is said to be forward biased. If my voltage across the diode is negative, then I'll say that my diode is said to be reverse biased. So can I find my voltage across the diode? Yes, because when this is an open circuit, no current flows through this, so no drop. So when there is no drop here, my voltage is given by VD is equal to -4 - 0, that is -4 volts. Okay, so when this is -4 volts, that is it is less than 0. So that means my diode is said to be reverse biased. Okay. Okay. So this may be the last example with which we will be very much familiar with finding out whether the given diode in the present in the given circuit is either in the forward bias region or in the reverse bias region. Okay. The diode is said to be forward biased only when my potential at the P side is more than the potential at the N side. Okay. So if you could find out this particular voltage, let us denote with X. Okay, if it is more than the 6 volts, right, then I'll say that my diode is said to be forward biased. Okay, see, don't think that there is a resistor, there will be some drop here. I don't know exactly what is the potential that is tied to the N terminal and so on and so forth. Okay, so there is nothing like that. Just think over that. To the N side, what has been connected is this particular 6 volts, so that to the P side, you always identify that if it is greater than the 6 volts, which is tied to the N terminal, then it is said to be forward biased. If the P side potential, which is Vx, is less than the 6 volts, then you say that it is said to be reverse biased. Okay. So only our task is to find out what is this particular voltage, that is Vx. Okay. So I think you know how to apply the KCL at this particular node. So apply KCL at this particular node. Okay, apply KCL at this particular node X, then it is been given by Vx -12/8, okay, plus Vx by 4, and when this is conducting, okay, I replace this with short circuit so that the current through this diode or current through this 2 ohm resistor is same as Vx -6/2, okay, plus Vx -6/2 is equal to 0. Okay, is equal to 0. So when I solve this, okay, so it is a matter of simplification. So when I solve this, I'll be getting my Vx as, okay, Vx as 5 volts. So Vx is 5 volts means, is it greater than the 6 volts or less than the 6 volts? So Vx is 5 volts, which is less than the 6 volts. That means my potential at P side is less than the potential at the N side. That means my diode is said to be a reverse biased. Okay. So this diode is said to be a reverse biased. When this is reverse biased, what is the current flowing through this? The current flowing through this is 0 amperes. Okay. So this is how you will be trying to find out whether your diode is in the forward bias or reverse bias. If it is in a reverse bias, you know that current through it is 0 amperes, at least ideally. Okay, right? Fine. Let us look at the diode characteristics.
So this is how the diode characteristics are going to look like. When your diode is in the forward bias region, the current voltage relationship is like this. When your diode is in the reverse bias region, the current voltage relationship is like this. Okay. So what is our observation is, until a certain voltage, let it be denoted with V gamma, my current through the diode is zero. And beyond this particular voltage, let us say V gamma, okay, it is normally called as cut-in voltage. My current is rising exponentially. Okay, so beyond the voltage applied across the diode is more than the so-called cut-in voltage. My current starts rising exponentially. That is what is our observation. And when the diode is in the reverse bias, okay, though we said that diode has a property that it conducts only in one direction, it stops the current flow in the other direction, but in practice there will be some current, okay, denoted by this Is, okay, there will be some current that is flowing even in the reverse bias condition, okay, that is being denoted by Is, which is normally called as reverse saturation current, okay, which is normally called as reverse saturation current, okay. And the relationship between the current and the voltage is given by ID is equal to Is into the reverse saturation current into e power Vd by Vt, okay, minus 1, okay. Now you look at here, my ID is given by Is into e power Vd by Vt minus 1. This I am writing it as Id into e power Vd by Vt minus Is. Okay. This minus Is is the current that is flowing through your device when your device is said to be reverse bias. Okay. I told that this is the current that is flowing through your device when your device is said to be reverse biased. So that means the sum of the current that is flowing when it is forward biased and the current that is flowing when it is reverse biased is what is nothing but your current through the diode. And because this is very small compared to this particular current, I am neglecting this. So in forward bias, okay, I'll assume that this current is very small compared to this current, so that my ID is given by Is into e power Vd by Vt. Okay, my ID is given by, right, Is into e power Vd by Vt. When I am saying that my diode is said to be in the forward bias region, I can comfortably apply this particular equation, assuming that my reverse saturation current is very small compared to the forward biased current. Okay, right. Okay. So ID is equal to Is into e power Vd by Vt. If my applied voltage is Vd1, let my current due to Vd1 be Id1, so that Id1 is given as Is into e power Vd1 by Vt. Okay, Id1 is equal to Is into e power Vd1 by Vt. Similarly, Id2 is equal to Is into e power Vd2 by Vt. Okay, so if my applied voltage across the diode is Vd1, my current through the diode be denoted with Id1. If my applied voltage across the diode is Vd2, my current through the diode is denoted by Id2. Now, if I try to find out what is my Id2 by Id1, then what is that I will be getting? Id2 by Id1, I will get it as e power Vd2 minus Vd1 by Vt. Okay, e power Vd2 minus Vd1 by Vt. Okay. So, okay, from this, can I get an expression for my Vd2 minus Vd1? Yes, my Vd2 minus Vd1 can be written as Vt ln of Id2 by Id1. Taking natural logarithm on both sides, ln of Id2 by Id1 is equal to Vd2 minus Vd1 by Vt. So that Vd2 minus Vd1 is given as Vt ln Id2 by Id1. Okay. So what is that I can write? I can write that my Vd2, okay, my Vd2 minus Vd1, okay, I can write it as VT ln, okay, VT ln ID2 by ID1. Okay, so this is an important relationship that what we have to understand. Okay, right. So this ID1 is the current due to the VD1, ID2 is the current due to the VD2, and VD2 minus VD1 is given as VT ln ID2 by ID1. Okay, right. So in the reverse bias, my ID is given by minus IS. Yes or no? In the reverse bias, my current ID is given by minus IS. That is what we have seen earlier. Sum of the forward bias current plus the reverse bias current. As this is small compared to the forward bias current, we have neglected when we are in the forward bias region. Okay. So now when we are in the reverse bias region, my ID is being given by minus IS, which is the reverse saturation current. Okay. Which is completely temperature dependent. Okay. So IS is a temperature dependent. Okay. IS is temperature dependent. It doesn't depend on the VR. Okay. It doesn't depend on the voltage applied across the diode in the reverse bias. Okay. It depends only on the temperature. Okay. And for every 10 degree centigrade rise in temperature, this reverse saturation current is going to get doubled. Okay. So my IS, let us say at a temperature T2, okay, is always given by my IS at a temperature T1 into 2 power T2 minus T1 by 10. Okay. So what is this equation is? My IS is always going to get doubled when my temperature is increasing by 10 degrees. So reverse saturation current is always a temperature dependent. It will never dependent on the reverse bias voltage that is applied. Okay. Right. Okay. So now let us look at the resistance levels. Okay. Concerned with the diode. The first thing is static or DC resistance denoted with capital R suffix capital D. Okay. And just now we have seen that these are the characteristics of your diode. Suppose if I am locating my operating point somewhere here, okay, let us say Q, then my corresponding voltage as well as corresponding current are fixed. Okay, my voltage here is V and my current here is D. Okay, let us say that this is voltage across the diode and this is current through the diode. Right, then my RD is given by, okay, then my RD is given by VD by ID. Okay. When once this point Q is fixed, then this VD is fixed and ID is fixed, then this RD is fixed. Okay, that is why it is called as static resistance or dynamic resistance. Okay, so when in your circuit involving your diode, if a DC voltage is applied, then your operating point is going to be fixed, then accordingly your resistance is offered by your diode is also going to be fixed, and it is called as DC or static resistance. And how do I find it? Just I'll take the point at which I am operating my device, then my corresponding voltage and my corresponding current. Okay, so VD by ID, I'll be getting my static resistance, that is RD. Okay. Now let us consider AC or dynamic resistance RD. Okay, this is denoted by small r suffix small d. Earlier it is capital R suffix capital D. Now it is small r suffix small d. So as long as your applied input signal is a DC quantity, then there is no issue with the resistance. But if your input signal is, okay, so you have chosen your operating point here, okay. Suppose if you are applying your input signal as AC, okay, if your AC signal is varying like this, okay, then your operating point is no more constant, okay. When your input signal is here, your operating point is this. When your input signal is this, okay, your operating point is, okay, your operating point has shifted to here. Okay, operating point means nothing but your voltage. At this point, your voltage is this Q plus this particular input signal value. Okay, similarly, when your input is here, then your Q point is going to be this value plus this value, AC plus DC. Okay, so my operating point is likely to vary in between these two points in the upper half portion. Similarly, when your input signal is going in the negative portion, okay, then also your operating point is going to vary up to this particular point. So with the variation in your input signal, your operating point is going to vary, okay, around this Q point. Okay, when there is no input signal at all, then your Q point is this. But when your input signal is floating on top of this DC, then your Q point is going to vary. So when your Q point is varying, now your resistance is no more a constant, it is a dynamic resistance, which is being denoted by RD. Okay, now how do I find the resistance RD? Okay, I'll find the resistance RD, okay, by using the equation what we have as ID is equal to, okay, IS into, okay, ID is equal to IS into e power VD by VT. Okay, so I'll take the derivative of this at a point Q, then I'll try to find out my dynamic resistance or AC resistance, that is RD. Okay, so at a point Q means, at a point Q, what is my voltage is VD, what is my current is ID. So that means you take the derivative of this, okay, take the derivative of this, okay, dou ID by dou T, dou VD, okay, at a point Q, okay, where Q is nothing but your voltage is VD and your current is ID. So that means replace your current with ID and voltage with VD upon taking the derivative of this particular function, then you will be getting your dynamic resistance R. Is this okay? How we are finding the AC or dynamic resistance RD? We are taking our current equation. I am differentiating with respect to VD. At a point Q, okay, at a point Q, it will be giving me my dynamic resistance, that is RD. Okay. Okay. So dou ID by dou VD at a Q point is what is being given by 1 by RD. Okay. Because R is normally V by I. So I by D is going to be 1 over RD. Right. So dou ID by dou VD is given as IS into derivative of e power x is e power x, but it is not x, it is VD by VT. So 1 by VT. Okay. So this entire thing is nothing but your small id, okay, so id by vt. But you need to consider at a point Q, okay, where your V is VD and your I is ID. So when I replace my I suffix capital D with, okay, capital ID, then I'll be getting my 1 over RD, okay, then I'll be getting my 1 over RD. So RD is being given by, okay, so RD is being given by, okay, VT by ID. Okay, RD has been given by VT by ID. Okay, so your dynamic resistance is dependent on the DC bias current. Okay, your dynamic resistance, which is variable, okay, with respect to your applied input sinusoidal signal, is dependent on DC bias current. Okay, DC bias current. The more the DC bias current, the less the variation you could see in your dynamic resistance. Okay, so that is why you have to always prefer, while choosing your operating point, the current needs to be very, very large, so that your dynamic resistance is going to be very, very small. Okay, so this VT is going to be 26 millivolts at room temperature. Okay, so this is regarding dynamic resistance. So two type of resistances we have seen. One is static resistance and the other is dynamic resistance. Okay, right. So now let us see the equivalent circuits. Equivalent circuit means it is approximation of the terminal characteristics of the device. Okay, so our actual terminal characteristics of the diode are shown by this white line. Okay, where my mathematical equation is shown with an exponential relationship. So using this exponential relationship is somewhat a bit difficult, okay, all the time when we want to go ahead with circuit analysis involving these diodes. Okay, so if there is a possibility, okay, we'll try to approximate so that with less accuracy we'll be getting the solution for the circuit which is involving our diodes. Okay, so that is what is an equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit means, okay, combination of elements, okay, that are being properly chosen in such a way that they best represent the terminal characteristics of the device. Okay, so the actual terminal characteristics are shown by the white. Okay, but mathematically it is shown like this, but it is very difficult. No doubt that when we use this particular equation, we will be getting very, very much accurate results. But engineers are not worried too much about the accurate results, but they are always look for approximating the things. If they are compromised with whatever the accuracy, that way that they get. Okay, so let us start with why don't we approximate our characteristics with this kind of characteristics. Okay, so this kind of characteristics are what is called as ideal characteristics. Okay, so this characteristics, okay, are called as ideal characteristics. So I can approximate my terminal characteristics of the diode with the help of this characteristics, what are called as ideal. What do I mean by that? When my V zero, my current is found to be infinity. Okay, that means for a positive voltage applied across the diode. Okay, so my diode is shown here. Okay, my diode is shown here. When a positive voltage is applied across the diode, okay, then my current through the diode, okay, then my current through the diode is given by infinity. Okay, then my current through the diode is being given by infinity, right? Okay, so that means I can replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay, I can replace my diode with a short circuit when I am using this particular model. Okay, so when I am using this particular ideal model, when my diode is forward bias, I can replace that with short circuit. Okay, so why short circuit? Because my current is found to be infinity when my diode is forward biased. Okay, but this is a very crude approximation. Okay, when you look at your actual characteristics, until a particular voltage, let us say V gamma, cut in voltage, there is no current at all. Okay, but you are saying that when once your voltage is positive, that is more than enough for making that your current is infinity. Okay, so very crude approximation, but okay, with less accuracy that you will be able to find some solution for the given circuit that involves your diode. Okay, so it is a very easiest way of using or solving your problems when this model is being taken care. So ideal diode approximation means when your diode is forward biased, replace your diode with short circuit. Okay, and when your diode is being made reverse biased, okay, when your diode is made reverse biased, replace that with an open circuit. Okay, replace that with an open circuit. Okay, so this is what is an ideal diode model is going to tell you. Okay, so this is what is the ideal diode model means. So whenever you are asked to analyze the circuit using a model that is an ideal diode model, then you replace your diode with your short circuit if it is forward biased, replace your diode with a open circuit if it is reverse biased. Okay, right? Okay, okay. So now let us increase our accuracy. Okay, let us have a some more better approximation, right? So this time I am saying that my current through the device is infinity, but not at zero, but instead let it be at some voltage, let it be some V gamma. Okay, right? So what is our next approximation? So this approximation is what is called as, okay, this approximation is what is called as constant voltage drop model. Constant voltage drop. Okay, so our assumption is whenever the diode is being conducting, there exists some drop across the diode denoted by this V gamma. Okay, so that means in the constant voltage drop model, your diode has to be replaced with, okay, your diode has to be replaced with a voltage source. Okay, let us say that how much it is V gamma. For a silicon it is 0.7 volts, from 0.5 to 0.7 volts. For germanium it is in between 0.3 to 0.5 volts. Okay, so replacing your diode with a voltage source which is V gamma, okay, is what is the constant voltage drop model means. Okay, so whenever your diode is in forward biased, when we are using this particular model, your diode has to be replaced with a voltage drop of V gamma. Okay, so this is what is constant voltage drop model. See, just slightly we are increasing our accuracy. Earlier the voltage drop across the diode is zero, simply we have made this short circuit, voltage across the diode is zero. Okay, but now we are assuming that the voltage across the diode is some constant, and that too it is given by the voltage drop, that is V gamma. Okay, so for a silicon it is roughly 0.7, for germanium it is around 0.3 volts. Okay, is this okay? So whenever we were asked to find the analysis of circuit involving diodes using this constant voltage drop model, wherever diode is there, if it is forward biased, replace the diode with a voltage source given by V gamma. Okay, if it is reverse biased, again the current through the diode is zero. Okay, so now we will see a further improvement in the accuracy, okay, with the help of this particular model. Okay, so this model is called as piecewise, okay, this model is called as piecewise linear model. Okay, so in the piecewise linear model, I can replace my diode with, okay, I can replace my diode with short circuit. Diode is being replaced with short circuit, but in addition to that, there is a voltage source, that is V gamma. Okay, there is a voltage source, that is V gamma, but at the same time there is a resistance, because the slope is there, so that is a resistance. Let it be denoted with some R. Okay, let it be denoted with some R. Okay, right. So this is what is the model that we will be using, okay, in the piecewise linear model. So the most accurate model among the three models, ideal diode model, constant voltage drop model, and piecewise linear model, piecewise linear model has got more accuracy. Okay, but it takes some time when we go ahead with the analysis, but the accuracy is quite good, acceptable. In general, most of the people go ahead with the constant voltage drop model, where the accuracy is also a bit satisfied, as well as the level of speed with which we can go ahead with the analysis of circuits is also satisfied. Okay, so whereas this ideal model, it is very easy for the analysis, but the accuracy is very, very less. Okay, so because this is a very crude approximation, that my voltage is going to be short circuited when it is forward biased and open circuited when it is reverse biased. So these are the three important, okay, equivalent circuits that we will be using in our particular course. And there is a one more model, what is called as small signal diode model, that we will see very soon. Okay, so the last model that we are going to see is a small signal model. Okay, so consider a diode. Okay, so that I am applying an AC signal on top of the DC signal. Let us say that this is my capital VD, this is my AC signal, let us say small VD, and my voltage across the diode is small suffix capital D, and my current through the circuit is small suffix capital. Okay, right. So always my current is given by small ID is equal to, okay, small ID is equal to capital IS into e power small VD by VT. So look at here, this is an instantaneous value, small I suffix capital D. So that is always given as capital ID plus small ID. Okay, so that is always given as IS into e power VD by VT. But this VD is nothing but capital VD plus small VD. Okay, so IS into e power VD by VT into e power VD by VT. So this I can write it as capital ID into e power small VD by capital VT. When I assume that small VD by VT is much less than 1, okay, then I can write that e power small VD by VT as, okay, 1 plus small VD by VT. Okay, so when I replace my exponential with that expression, ID into 1 plus VD by VT. Okay, so always my small I suffix capital D is always given as capital ID plus small ID. So that what is my small ID is given by ID by VT into small VD. Okay, right. So my small ID is given as capital ID by VT into small VD. Okay, so that small VD by small id, okay, V is equal to IR, R is equal to V by I, so which is nothing but RD, okay. What is RD? RD is nothing but VT by ID, okay. So V by I is nothing but VT by, so that is nothing but VT by ID. What we have seen earlier, that my dynamic resistance is given by VT by ID. So whenever we are in the small signal model, okay, I'll replace my diode with this RD, okay. I'll replace my diode with this RD, okay. So this is what is the small signal model is. The larger the value of ID, the smaller the dynamic resistance RD. That we have seen in the dynamic resistance concept itself, okay. Okay, so let us solve one problem which makes use of the small signal model. Okay, the problem is like this. You are given the drop across the diode as 0.7 volts and VT is equal to 25 millivolts and the input that is applied is VP cos omega T, so that VP is given as 100 millivolts. And this is the circuit. So the circuit consists of diode 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 diodes which are connected in series. And the input is applied is VI and there is a DC on top of which input is riding, that is 12.7 volts. We were asked to find out ID through diodes, okay. So this is a capital, that means DC bias current, okay. So we were asked to find out what is the DC bias current that is flowing through the diodes. And the second one is, what is the AC output voltage between these two terminals, okay. So this is what the output voltage that we need to find. Both are small, means AC output voltage. So this is what is the question. So the question is, we need to find the AC output voltage and we need to find the DC bias current that is flowing, okay. So let me tell you how to proceed with this problem, then we can solve for the numericals, okay. So for getting the DC bias current that is flowing through the diodes, okay, so the current that is flowing in this way, if I want a DC bias current that is flowing through all the diodes, then you have to make your AC short circuit. That means you make your AC source zero. So voltage source making zero means short circuited. So you short circuit so that the current that is flowing through is given by this voltage minus from here to here, okay, your drop across the voltage is given as 0.7 volts whenever they are conducting. Only when they are conducting, then only there is a possibility for the current to flow. So when they are conducting, the drop is being given as 0.7. So 0.7 volts across this diode, 0.7 volts across this diode, 0.7 volts across this diode, and 0.7 volts across this diode. So 2.8. So 2.8 volts is from here to here, that is on one side of the resistor, and the 12.7 volts is on the other side of the resistor. So the current through the resistor, which is nothing but your bias current, is given as 12.7 volts minus 2.8 volts divided by 9900 ohms, okay. So this is how we find the bias current that is flowing through your diodes, okay, right, okay. Just let us see first qualitatively, then we will plug in the values, okay. So next we need to find out is AC output voltage. So while finding the AC output voltage, so we need to make my DC quantity zero. So that means make this 12.7 volts zero. That means you short this and replace your diode with a small signal resistance, that is RD. I told you that in the case of an AC signal, you have replace your diode with a small signal resistance. What is your small signal resistance is RD. What is RD is capital VT by ID. What is capital VT is 25 millivolts. What is the ID is we have calculated in the previous case. So that VT by ID is what is your RD. Replace each diode with, okay, RD. Okay, so here RD, 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 right. So 4 RD, because R is in the series. So 4 RD, drop across 4 RD is what is your output voltage is. Okay, is what is your output voltage is, right. So we will try to plug in this concept in order to find the numericals, okay, right, okay. So when we look at the first case, ID is equal to 12.7 minus 2.8 by 9900, okay. Why 12.7? Because we are making our AC voltage 0, so the 12.7 minus
each diode has a drop of 0.7, so 4.7 is 2.8, so divided by the resistance is 9900 ohms. Okay, so that is why we will be getting a 1 ohm current, which is the DC bias current. Okay, for the second case, okay, as I told you that you will be replacing your DC voltage source with short circuit, so that you will be having your AC. AC is given as 100 millivolts times cos omega t, and you need to replace all your diodes with the small RD. Small RD is given as capital VT by ID. So what is capital VT? 25 millivolts by ID is 1 milli amperes. So your RD is given by 25 ohms. So replace your each diode with RD, that is 25 ohms, 25 ohms, 25 ohms, 25 ohms. Okay. So that what is your output voltage? You can write it as, okay, apply the voltage division rule. Your input voltage, your source voltage is Vi here, one resistance here, another resistance here. How much is this resistance across which you are taking the output? That is 4 RD. Okay. So my output voltage, which is across 4 RD, is given as output voltage is equal to Vi into, okay, 4 RD. RD is nothing but your 25 ohms divided by 4 RD plus this particular resistance, that is 9900. Okay. And your Vi is being anyway given 100 millivolts times cos omega t. So what is my output is given by cos omega t millivolts. Okay, my output is given by 1 cos omega t millivolts.